So now we're sitting here with Lori Kahn of Love
Between the Covers.
Between the Covers, which unfortunately I didn't see. So tell us all about it, Lori.
So Love Between the Covers is about the romance novel global community of women who read them, write them.
Can I say the name Louise Penny?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know who she is.
Yeah, she's English, isn't she?
No, she's Canadian. She's Canadian. We write on Facebook together.
Good.
To each other. And so that's my romance connection to today. She writes incredibly successful detective fiction set in Quebec, which isn't exactly romance, but there's always romance in it somewhere. But it's a female, and she's wildly successful. Oh my God.
Well, romance in general is wildly successful. It's a multi-billion-dollar industry, and it's keeping the rest of publishing afloat.
Really? Okay. Okay, I'm glad to hear that.
And all the big publishing houses now have romance divisions, which are basically paying for the rest of the publishing house. And these women...
So this was a doc you had.
It's a documentary, and it's very surprising. I mean, people think of lonely, pathetic women reading romance because they have no love in their lives.
Exactly.
And it's not the case at all. In fact, romance writers and readers have a better percentage chance of having a long-term successful relationship than the population at large.
I have to see a movie for sure.
But it's also, everybody thinks of bodice rippers, right? Fabio on the cover and bodice rippers. But there is everything now from evangelical Christian romance, Amish romance, all the way through historical, time travel, suspense, paranormal with vampires and werewolves, erotic, lesbian, male-male, BDSM on the far end of the spectrum. So that's pretty big from Christian.
Just about everybody's reading it.
Yeah.
And see, I thought your film was a fiction film.
No.
About, you know, something soap opera-esque or something, and it wasn't that at all. Gosh, I'm sorry, I didn't see it.
No, it's okay. I mean, it'll be screening again at 2:30 in Wellfleet.
And we'll be here. Yeah.
Too bad. But it'll be around. It'll be in theaters, and it'll be...
The opening night film?
No, I wasn't. Yeah.
Okay, I was mixing that up with this other film that I skipped, but anyway. So, Wellfleet's lovely. We were just there yesterday.
Yeah, good. But it's one of those rare documentaries that is funny and fun and also packs a punch.
How many years did it take to shoot it?
I was actually shooting for 3 years. So I followed five successful authors.
Who were? Should we mention their names?
Yeah. So one of them is, her writing name is Eloisa James, and her real name is Mary Bly. She's actually the daughter of Robert Bly, who is a Shakespeare scholar by day, romance author by night. Another of the authors is Len Barreau, whose writing name is Radcliffe, who did Q&A with me yesterday, who is a surgeon who is writing lesbian romances. Another of the authors is an African-American woman named Beverly Jenkins, who is totally lovable. And we went on trips with her fans, her readers.
Wow.
To places where her novels are set.
And she has presumably an African-American audience.
She has an African, mostly, but not exclusively, African-American audience. And these women know more about African-American history than the guides. I mean, and they're in touch all the time. They're like, you know, she's speaking to her fans 3 times a day. And she says, quite honestly, she said, my readers got me through my husband's death. I mean, it's not a normal fandom. It's not just adulation and sort of marketing the social media.
Like Louise Penny, her husband has developed Alzheimer's since she started writing. So there's this huge community of support for her and
That's
her
right.
husband.
That's right. Same thing. And it's widespread and it's very female. And the Romance Writers of America organization has 10,000 members.
Wow.
And anybody is welcome to join. You don't have to be a published author. And so
okay,
it's like,
I'm signing up right now.
It's, you know, come on in, sister. And then there are workshops where women who are aspiring authors learn how to write. I mean, it's a very pay it forward ethic. Like, somebody helped me when I started, and I'm going to reach behind me and help somebody else. And it's not bullshit. They really do it.
Wow. Wow. And the name of your wonderful film, once again, which is a doc, I'll have to make it clear, is?
Love Between the Covers.
Okay. Thank you so much, Laura,
well,
for dropping by today here at the beautiful Providence.
It's gorgeous.
I love your garden, by the way.
It's gorgeous. Okay, thank you so much.
All right, bye-bye.